Shalom, everyone. Giving all praises to the Most High, Elohim, and His word and His truth. It's your boy, G-Dash, the Prophet. I'm back with Esau, part three.
Now we back with part three, proving Esau is not the so-called white man. You Hebrew Israelites are quick to say,
I want the truth!
But do you really want the truth? Because when we tell you the truth, guess what?
You can't handle the truth!
Exactly.
You can't handle the truth!
Exactly. You can't handle the truth.
Împotriva islamismului, împotriva edomiților, împotriva lumii arabe.
God is against the Islam, the Edomites, the Arab world.
Then you'll know who is Mystery Babylon.
Din Edom și din Ismael.
Because again, from Edom and Ishmael,
s-a născut lumea arabă.
We have the Arab world.
Care este lumea islamică de astăzi, în cea mai mare parte.
Which is the majority of the Islamic world today.
This shape creates a three-dimensional cube or house for these gods, which is exactly the shape of the Kaaba itself. But that's not all. Seeing as the Babylonian sun god was the supreme ruler over these other gods, or constellations, its number was placed outside the square, the very same position in which we find the 666 on the Babylonian seal. Is the exact same position we find the Kaaba stone built into the Kaaba's wall. Without doubt, the Kaaba stone is intricately connected with Babylonian sun worship and worship of the heavens. The very name Kaaba in English means square or cube. It's the same magic square the Babylonians used to worship their sun god.
Also, I showed you guys in part one, right? Where in Google, they showed you that Amalek, the grandson of Esau, they showed you when you scrolled down that the Edomite religion was to a stone cube representation of God. The Edomite religion was to a stone cube representation of God. Who is that today? The Arabs. Everything is pointing right back to them.
The prophet Jeremiah saw the destruction of the Arabian Peninsula. Edom will become an object of horror. No one will live there or dwell in it. Hear what the Lord has planned against Edom. What he purposed against all who live in Timan. At the sound of their fall, the earth will tremble. The cry will resound to the Red Sea. The very sea that Mystery Babylon sits near is the Red Sea. But where is Edom and where is Timan? In scripture, the ancient nation of Edom stretches from Yemen, Timan, to northern Saudi Arabia, Dedan. Ezekiel 25 says, I will stretch out my hand against Edom and kill both man and beast. I will lay it waste from Timan to Dedan. Isaiah 21. A prophecy against the desert by the sea. Against Duma. Someone calls to me from Seir. A prophecy against Arabia. You caravans of Dedanites, who camp in the thickets of Arabia. You who live in Tema, within 1 year, all the splendor of Kedar will come to an end. Where is Duma, Seir, Arabia, Tema, and Kedar? It's in the Arabian Peninsula, in modern-day Saudi Arabia. Exactly as the prophets John, Jeremiah, and Isaiah said. Arabia is known in Arabic because Al-Jazira, Al-Arabia, meaning the Arab island, or the desert by the sea. The original Babylon is not located near the sea, but Mystery Babylon is. And the 10 horns, which thou sawest upon the beast, these shall hate the harlot, and shall make her desolate and naked, and shall eat her flesh, and burn her with fire.
Saudi Arabia is the font of all evil, and let me explain how the record supports my point of view. Sunni extremists, Al-Shabaab, Boko Haram, ISIS, Al-Qaeda, Osama bin Laden himself, a Saudi. Saudis have bought off so much of America's intelligentsia and political punditry that they have totally conned the world. They have totally conned the world. They have totally conned the world.
We are directly complicit with what the outrages the Saudis are committing in Yemen. Why are we doing it? Why do we have this very close relationship with the House of Saud, which also, let's add, is one of the biggest supporters of international terrorism, maybe the biggest in the globe. I think a lot of it has to do with arms deals, with the kind of sales we make to the Saudis, but also let's not ignore the fact they spend several billion dollars a year peddling influence in this town. They were one of the biggest purveyors of lighting services here, and it counts. They basically own this town. They basically own this town. They basically own this town.
That's right. Esau, the Saudi Arabians, they basically own this town. They own Washington, D.C. They own Fox News. They own everything, man. They own America. But you sleeping.
Oh, you like, well, where's Arabia? Where's the Arab? Where they at? Where they at?
They own this town. It's called deception, buddy. You ever heard of it?
Arabia Saudita va fi nimicită cu desăvârșire.
Saudi Arabia will be completely destroyed.
În războiul acesta din Psalmul 83.
In this war that's mentioned in Psalm 83.
Și nu vom mai avea nici o rămășiță care să rămână în mileniu.
And they will not have any remnants that survive into the millennial kingdom.
Nu uitați că în Arabia Saudită este ceea ce am putea numi scriptural unul din locurile unde este scaunul de domnie al satanei.
Don't forget that in Saudi Arabia we have what we could call biblically one of the thrones of Satan.
Mecca.
Mecca.
If you would like to watch the rest of this video, please join my online school. Once again, those that know, I don't teach online no more, or at least on YouTube anymore. So to get access to this full video, please join my online school. Hit the link in the description of this video. Peace and shalom.
It's not what you know, it's what you can prove.